Welcome back, guys. Looks like we got to speak with the scientists, which seems like they're up here. I think. Or. I guess they're down here. Wait.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine. My arm's got the brunt of it.
Stuff exploding like this happen often?
Back right after the mutiny, we had a lot of this happening. But not lately.
I wasn't there during the mutiny.
Lucky. I thought we were done with this, honestly. That maybe I was just being paranoid.
What is there to be paranoid about?
We've had 3 malfunctions in the past week.
That's not good. Sorry, understatement.
Yeah. And now I have more repairs.
Did you talk to security about this?
How can I? For all I know, someone in security is the one doing this. I've scanned all the potential sabotage areas I can think of. But I don't know who to trust anymore.
Sounds like a lot went down before the Hyperion docked.
Yeah, I guess. Wait. That's it. You can't possibly be involved in this. You weren't even here during the mutiny. Would you, if you have time? Maybe you could help me. If they start hitting critical systems.
Sure.
Sure thing. What can I do?
If you could scan these other panels while I fix this one, that'd really help. I've sent the locations to your Omni-tool. Just send me the data when you're done.
No, I'm fine. And I don't...
Find out why. Be careful.
Okay, let's go find those other panels.
But the planet was toxic. What if they store oxygen in porous tissue, like Quiro's rockfish?
Alright, I gotta find... other panels. Dude's on that panel. Okay.
Hey, Herrick, how about you not dissect things over lunch? It's weird.
Professor Herrick. Okay, it looks like I can't even do that. Understand what I'm supposed to be doing. What is this?
Hello, I'm Jian Garson, founder of the initiative.
Oh, Jesus.
It's through your hard work that the vision of the Nexus has come to life. You and all your colleagues bind our proud new colonies together. Look around at your achievements. And if you have any questions, my door is always open.
Founder Garson's office is located at workspace not allocated. Please select a topic. Viable planets capable of supporting life are key to our survival in Andromeda. The viability of a world is affected by several factors, including temperature, resources, threat levels, political stability, and so on. We have few viable planets currently within range. Resource levels are considered at risk.
Okay.
Integration from the Hyperion is ongoing. Personnel are still restricted to operations. The selection process saw the Andromeda Initiative evaluate thousands of potential habitable planets within the galaxy. After discovering an unusually high ratio of potential candidates, or Golden Worlds, the Helios Cluster was selected as our destination. Even at a distance, studying the light from stars can reveal much about their planet's composition and atmosphere. Seven worlds, nicknamed Habitats, have the life-supporting environments and resources we need to start our new lives in Andromeda.
I see. Okay. Why?
All personnel, be aware of suspicious activity. Security is on high alert.
Well, I guess I can't do that. Okay then. Fuck it, I suppose. Gonna go see there's a marker over here.
We can start building a bank of back. You must be the Pathfinder. Wonderful. You and your Sam are exactly what we need.
Thanks, Mr.
Professor Heerick. My colleagues and I will work with your Sam and the data you gather to solve Andromeda's scientific mysteries.
What fields do you study?
Heerick's in the life sciences. I do planetary geology, oceanography, rocks and runoff. Aradana's the space and math whiz.
Not that we've had much to study, with everyone cooped up for 14 months.
But your data on the Scourge flows like poetry. Now we can better advise on repairing the damage it caused.
And maybe Addison will give us a real workspace. Who can think with all this racket?
Fair enough. Let's skill up. Yay. What's tech? Overload. Overload causes it to chain. Tactical cloak. Recharge speed. Yay. Okay. Chest. Okay, interesting. Alright, I think we're good now. Alright, let's get her going. Let's get the fuck out of here. Oh, this is interesting. A lot of tension. A lot of things going on. It's gonna be interesting. Oh, other side. Who are you?
Pathfinder. Good to see you. Word is, there's been trouble on the station.
We just got here. How did you know that already?
Word gets around.
Does it now?
People talk to me? Anyway, as soon as we establish outposts, everything will even out. I'm sure of it.
Have to go now. See you later.
Later.
Interesting. I don't have a marker for the panels and stuff, so let's just get right to it.
Hello, Ryder. Welcome back to Sam Node. I've adjusted my connection to your implant. The headache you experienced before shouldn't reoccur.
Yeah, what was that about? You said we need to discuss something confidential.
You should know certain facts before you leave on your expedition. It seemed best we speak alone.
I don't understand the need for secrecy.
Your father felt it was for the best.
What was he trying to hide?
My true capabilities. Alec overrode the implant safety protocols. It allows me unrestricted access to the Pathfinder's physiology.
And that's me now.
And only you. I can act as a force multiplier, dramatically enhancing your motor and neural skills when required. Alec called them profiles. They provide unique, tactical augmentation during combat. Your father preferred to keep this fact to himself.
I can understand. People might get the wrong idea. Super soldiers. A computer having control over a human.
Providing an enhancement to the human. It is a symbiotic relationship that benefits both.
What do you get out of it?
Though I'm artificial in design, I am fully sentient. Far beyond what even the Initiative understands.
I don't follow. You're an AI. So what's different?
I am a new form of AI, drawing directly from the human experience. Your implant is my window into the world.
How do human experiences affect a computer?
This was a question your father often pondered. I am intended to be the answer.
Sounds like we both are. What does this mean for us?
I find myself in an unusual position. Though I had access to your father's experiences, there is a gap in my understanding.
How so?
He placed a block on portions of my memory array.
Why?
Perhaps so when you asked me what his plan was, I wouldn't know.
And Dad strikes again.
But not without recourse. The further you explore as a Pathfinder, the more blocks will be removed. Perhaps you should begin in your father's quarters. In the meantime, unless you have more questions, your new ship awaits.
Thanks.
Ah. That's cool. Okay. So I'm guessing we could choose between augmentations. Container. Ready then.
Ready to see what Tan gave us?
I hear it's something special. Pathfinder en route. How's the ship?
In final checks, looking great.
We won't be long. The way things are going, we'll be on our own out there.
In other words, we're making this up as we go.
We used to call that tactical improvisation. But at least we'll be doing it in style.
I guess so.
They call her the Tempest.
Very nice.
Take a closer look.
Let's pick it up a bit, people. We're 14 months late.
So you're the one who's making everything happen. Vetra. Vetra Nix. Initiative Wrangler, Provisioner, Gunner, and everything in between. Are we ready? The sooner we get out of here, the better.
You're coming with us?
Yes. Otherwise, there's no way they're letting this ship off the station.
What's the rush?
Just don't want to waste any more time.
Hold it, hold it! You're not going anywhere.
Damn it.
Is something wrong?
Director Addison wants to see a complete report of the Tempest's supplies, munitions, and crew.
Director Tan overruled Addison.
The ship's loaded out with equipment for outpost discovery, squarely under Director Addison's purview.
Seen you around. Ben, right? Came here with a family, didn't you? Son still in cryo? I could pull some strings, get him to the front of the line.
Really?
Yeah, really.
They told me he wasn't essential, but I miss him.
I know. I got family too, Ben.
It's done. Madison's gonna kill me.
Nicely done.
Part of the job, Pathfinder. All things considered, it was an easy ask. And right now, you need people tearing down obstacles, not putting up more.
Jesus.
Someone who cares about doing stuff and not just talking about it.
Very interesting how this is going. Turmoil, people fighting against each other, things not going correctly. Seems about right. Not much we can do.
Everything's state of the art. Labs, sensors, exploration gear. Lesser crew, of course. The best in their field.
Ah, glad to see you looking well.
The engine core is based on the Ark's Odyssey drive.
It runs a hell of a lot quieter.
That's Gil Brody. Engineer, mechanic, all-around wrench jockey. We call this the research room. There's space for upgrading equipment, gathering intel.
Router engaged. Securing connection to Tempest.
Welcome aboard, Sam. And Ryder, of course.
All run by Suvi Anwar, our science officer. Your quarters are below. Plenty of space up here to get everyone together. It's all yours. She's light, stealthy, and the fastest ship in her class.
It's really gonna be something, isn't it?
I haven't even shown you the best part. When you're ready to fly, head over to the bridge. Our pilot should have everything good to go.
Huh.
Better head to the bridge when we're ready to go.
You can run research projects and coordinate with the Nexus from here.
Ladder? What is this place? Alright, I'm gonna do a bit of exploration in this. Ooh,
beds. These are the Pathfinder's quarters. Your quarters. Sam's router is down there too.
Well, there's Sam. Email terminal. Okay.
Verifying my connection from Hyperion to the Tempest. The Nexus confirms we're free to depart.
Wardrobe. Ooh. Jacket's nice. Ooh, I can customize the colors. What shall we use? Should we go as? Go all white? Huh? So hard to choose. No, we're gonna go white. Got a bit of orange going. Oh, that's where it is. We can make that black. Get her going. Got pimped out now. All good to go. Got a kitchen. What's this over here? Bathroom.
Most of the crew bunks in here. Cozy, huh? But your room. Room's got more of a view.
I see. This is Lexi.
Excuse me. I need to make sure we have everyone's medical files from the Nexus. Come by after launch, and we can catch up properly.
Okay. What's this? What am I looking at?
Ryder.
It's Cora. It's sure that we need to look at someone or find someone. So, Ryder. Let's... What?
Ryder. Finalizing orders, flight plan, command access. Ready when you are.
Okay. This is a pretty big ass ship. Goddamn.
Some serious kit over here.
Oh, yeah? This is where we came from.
That's the bio lab. We can grow plants for food and oxygen and keep any specimen safe.
I see. Alrighty then.
Pause button. Check this foot.
Our tech lab is an engineer's dream. It's perfect for any delicate technical work.
Pause button.
Alright, let's go check the toy real quick, since I'm curious.
Some serious kills.
Seems like
here.
We're forever racing, but there's always time to check out new toys. Useful ones.
Always game for new toys.
This makes use of old ones, like anything you grabbed on Habitat 7. Raw minerals, tech, doesn't matter. The research station will strip that stuff down, give you options.
We're on our own, for everybody else. That's what Pathfinder means now.
Yeah, well, everybody should be so lucky. This tech is aces. If the best we get is what we make, still the best. Check it out.
It's like research to unlock new blueprints, augmentations using the research data. You've acquired select deployment to craft new items and upgrades. Huh. Okay. Okay. Let's try the research center. Oh, wow. I'll have to understand that all later. But let's get into this. Let's go.
Departure trajectory locked, Nexus Control. Ah, time for introductions. You must be Ryder, Gallo-Jath. A pleasure to be here, and to meet you, of course. I'll be piloting the Tempest at your word. Quite the ship, but it'll take a Pathfinder's guidance to see us through Helios.
Plenty of dangers out there, but I'll do my best to avoid them.
That's reassuring. Wouldn't want to lose my finest work to that angry cloud. I was test pilot for the Tempest's early prototypes. I admit, I'm itching to see how she performs out here.
So how do I...
The console syncs with your implant. Just swipe, touch a destination here, and the nav system calculates everything. Very efficient.
It was optimized for a Pathfinder.
Everything's secure, if you're ready.
Is anyone ready for something this big?
We signed on for the big stuff when we came to Andromeda.
All right. Excuse me. Excuse me.
Command access is transferring successfully.
Science and monitoring stations look fine. Lexi's reporting in.
She's Scottish.
Gil
awesome.
Reports the drive core is online.
This is it, Ryder. The Tempest is yours. Unless you've got something to say for the log.
I never planned to be Pathfinder. I don't know what's out there. But we're the Milky Way's best and brightest. We can do this.
Nexus Control, this is the Tempest, Ident 2527, prepping to depart.
Let's do it. Let's see what this is all about.
Departure vector verified, Tempest. Godspeed, Pathfinder.
Oh.
To Eos, then. What would have been our habitat one?
Two field outposts put an end to that idea.
Maybe we can turn things around. Callow, take us in.
Oh, I love the Scottish girl. I don't know why. I just do. Let's go there. I'm guessing that's light speed.
This is about as far as the Nexus surveyors could get.
Light speed. Whatever.
Let's see what's waiting here. Anomaly detected. Anomaly detected.
I don't understand. Let's try that fucking. This is interesting, but weird. thick dust clouds, dangerous electrical storms, and heavy gravity render. Well, that sucked. Toxic, the most known life forms rise, helium rich atmosphere appears to most and to host enormous colonies of fungal spores.
Anomaly on sensors.
I gotcha. Let's go over there. Come on, show me the goods. That looks like a moon. I don't think this is habitable. Thanks to Kristen atmosphere, it's brutal cold deserts. Receive swimmingly high temperatures and direct sunlight. Limit exploration to twilight hours only. Okay.
Anomaly on sensors.
This didn't work out. Alright, we're gonna go to this one. Oh, there we go. I was wondering why it was going so slow. Let's go check this one out. There's gotta be something habitable, right? The outlying world is right. Excuse me. Comprised of frozen nitrogen, one oddly stands out. Certain geologist features suggest nitrogen seas were once liquid. That is negative 215 degrees Celsius.
I'm picking up something. Launched. Probe away. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
So that's what it does. Let's see what happens when you go and do that again. There's not been a game like this so far I know of. And this really pushes it. Hey. I see some blue and green. Extremely radioactive and high velocity winds make poor candidate for mining deposit and rich metal deposits. potential candidate for future endeavors. Well, that's a bum. Guessing, let's go look at the black hole. Hopefully we don't get sucked. That would suck. I'm so funny. Caution is advised. Okay, let's head back to the cluster map. Nothing over there. Now back to here.
System, Pythias. Andromeda Initiative Habitat 1. Designated EOS.
It was supposed to be an easy first step. Until no one else showed, and we got clobbered. Twice.
Why has Sam altered frequency detection?
What are we hearing, Sam?
There is a signal pathfinder. I recommend an immediate examination of EOS.
Interesting. Well, I'm gonna end this here, because that took a long time. Longer than I expected, of figuring out everything. But I will see you all in the next one. Adios.